Do you wish you just had a little more focus, a little more concentration? That's what we're talking about today. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com, and this is Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmeetails, just tell me what works. And today we're going to talk about how to improve focus and concentration with Alpha-GPC and Ginkgo Biloba, two supplements that I use. So part of being concentrated and focused is getting your dopamine straightened out, because that's what's going to provide the motivation to pay attention. And I've done some other stuff on dopamine that I'll link to in the description of this episode. But assuming you're motivated, once that dopamine is telling your brain that it's really important to pay attention to this particular thing, all of a sudden the importance of acetylcholine kicks in. And acetylcholine is what gives you the performance, the focus, and the results of sticking your attention on something. So I find that 300 milligrams of a supplement called Alpha-GPC plus 120 milligrams of Ginkgo Biloba taken every 3 or 4 hours can turn on the focused concentration part of my brain for analytical, creative, and intellectual work like fire. And the basis is as follows. Alpha-GPC, which stands for alpha-glycerophosphocholine, is a particular type of choline that is 10 times more effective at boosting your acetylcholine levels in your brain than any other type of choline. And this was originally developed because people who had defective acetylcholine synthesis had to take exorbitant amounts of choline to get their acetylcholine levels boosted that made them smell like fish because the choline was turned into things in their gut that make you smell like fish. And so this supplement as an alternative could be taken in much lower doses and boost acetylcholine levels much more effectively. It's primarily been studied in the modern era in terms of Alzheimer's disease, where 300 milligrams taken 4 times a day provides a very profound impact, a very profound benefit to the cognitive function of people with Alzheimer's. But acetylcholine more generally isn't just about preventing Alzheimer's disease, it's what gives you focused concentration. So Alpha-GPC is converted into acetylcholine. Then the Ginkgo Biloba has a natural acetylcholinesterase inhibitor. Acetylcholinesterase is the enzyme that breaks down acetylcholine. So if you take the Ginkgo Biloba, the acetylcholine that you produce from the Alpha-GPC will last longer in your brain and have more activity. So the combination of these two, Alpha-GPC raises the acetylcholine, Ginkgo Biloba prevents it from being broken down. Together, that's a pair that helps keep that focused concentration keep on going. I originally started taking these when I was going through a period where I hadn't been eating eggs. So my dietary choline was lower and I was really distracted. So I do think to some degree I was compensating for not getting enough choline. But even now that I'm eating 4 eggs a day and otherwise getting a lot of choline in my diet from other sources, I still benefit a lot from taking this combination. I want to say something though on cycling. I really don't think it's a good idea to take supplements that impact your brain function in a way like this, constant, nonstop, over very long periods of time. Because I think your brain is likely to get dependent on them and you're likely to develop a tolerance that causes the effect to wear off. And you really don't want the acetylcholine effect to wear off because this is speculative, but you could eventually down the road get less acetylcholine as a result of all the adaptations, and less acetylcholine really hurts your brain function, as in the case of Alzheimer's disease. So the way that I do this is I very selectively do this dosing schedule on the days that I've blocked out for my intellectual work. And that generally is 3 days a week where I'm doing hardcore intense concentration, like the research that goes into producing podcasts like this. And I just take them then. And then when I'm done with the intellectual work, I let it go. And I let my brain do other things for 4 days. So when I come back to it the next time, that my brain is fresh and I'm still getting that same response.
This episode is brought to you by Ancestral Supplements Living Collagen. Our Native American ancestors believed that eating the organs from a healthy animal would support the health of the corresponding organ of the individual. Ancestral Supplements has a nose-to-tail product line of grass-fed liver, organs, living collagen, bone marrow, and more, all in the convenience of a capsule. For more information or to buy any of their products, go to ancestralsupplements.com. This episode is brought to you by Ample. Ample is a meal in a bottle that takes a total of 2 minutes to prepare, consume, and clean up. It provides a balance of fat, protein, and carbs, plus all the vitamins and minerals you need in a single meal, all from a blend of natural ingredients. It's available in original, vegan, and keto versions. Portioned is either 400 or 600 calories per meal. I'm an advisor to Ample, and I use it to save time when I'm working on major projects on a tight schedule. It keeps my brain going while I power through the day, never letting food prep get in the way of my productivity. Head to amplemeal.com and enter the promo code CHRIS15 at checkout for a 15% discount off your first order. The audio of this episode was enhanced and post-processed by Bob Devodian of Torian Mixing. You can find more of his work at torianonlinemixing.com. For ad-free versions of these episodes with transcripts that you can read and getting early access to the episodes, often weeks or maybe even months ahead of time, you can sign up for the CMJ Masterpass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code LITE10 to get 10% lifetime discount.
All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. This has been Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next episode.